The village where you access the cable car is absolutely charming. Reminds me a bit of a Tai O fishing village in Hong Kong. Check out the details that they put into on the bridge and... Okay, I'm the first person here, so all I hear are birds and fish and waterfall. This is going to be so much fun. It's beautiful. Okay, well, I'm in the glass bottom cable car. And on our way up, it's going to be a few minutes ride up to the top, and then we'll do the sky glide, which is like a zipper car. That, or you can do a 10-minute walk through some really pretty trees, I imagine.
Well, it's absolutely crazy where down below it was blue sky and you could see the crystal aquamarine waters down below. Once we arrived to the middle station, it basically is cloud cover. It's crazy. Oh, you couldn't even see that. Coming up to the station, still in the clouds, can't see anything, it's crazy.
Okay, after my hella early 7 a.m. start, it's closed at the moment because we're inside of a cloud. So I'm reading people's love locks here. There's quite a lot of them. It's nice, actually. So chilling for a little bit till the SkyBridge opens. Well, I'm definitely the first person up. Happy about. It's so hot. We're literally in a cloud. So I'm basically going to camp out, I think, and wait for it to clear. Well, I've been waiting for sunshine and blue sky, and there's a bit of blue sky starting to peek out, but I'm just gonna call it. It's beautiful up here. Everyone's having a great time. Everybody's taking selfies. It's a really fun afternoon. I think better than morning. Headed down, it was a really good time up there. Here are my three tips for having an awesome time the Langkawi SkyBridge. First, definitely grab a glass bottom cable car because they rock. It's really much more fun. Number two, definitely take the Sky Glide. It's 30 seconds instead of like 12 minutes of stairs. So unless you're a super fitness buff, you're gonna see that as a plus. Definitely take the Sky Glide. Much better way to access the Sky Bridge. And number three, definitely take your shoes off and experience the horror and like fear of standing on a glass plate and looking down hundreds of feet. It was really terrifying. I actually asked to hold someone's hand at one point when I was first stepping on. It was just, wah. Definitely try that. It's worth it. It was a memorable part of my SkyBridge experience. Post-noon is better from a cloud standpoint, but there's definitely more people. I was the first person up on the SkyBridge. It was great. There were a few people the first, you know, hour. After that, it starts to get quite busy to the point of actually having a staff member count the number of people on the bridge and only allow certain people, so there starts to be a queue. So keep that in mind too.